needs energy, reliable, affordable, but also clean fuel. Oman has been ranked at the top globally when it comes to potential for renewables. And we have started looking at optimizing the system and changing any conventional energy production to more of a renewable one. And this is something that has been the focus recently. We have certain areas of Oman that are blessed with both solar and significant wind potential. And we want to capitalize on this to produce energy and therefore using that energy to produce things such as green hydrogen.
Main trends that are shaping the oil and gas sector globally, it affects Oman and the rest of the GCC. These include energy transition and decarbonization, the global underinvestment in the oil and gas industry, as well as the issue of energy security, where most countries are now looking at ensuring they have local energy supply or a diversified supply of energy. And finally, it's the rapid technological development and the significant investment in renewable technologies and green technologies. Oman is one of the countries that has signed up to a net zero target, which is 2050. Also looking to reduce emissions probably by 25% by 2030. This was one of the main topics of Vision 2040, and it included both renewable energy generation and also diversifying our economy away from oil and gas products.
So when you look at alternative energy, now that the world is moving towards decarbonization and looking at energy diversification as well as securing energy, Oman is primed in a position where it has natural resources that venture into alternative energy. And by venturing into alternative energy, that opens up a whole new sector for Oman to play in. That is outside of oil and gas, but yet still in the energy sector. High yields of solar and wind resources all year round allows you then to produce hydrogen through electrolysis. It's a whole new ecosystem that Oman can embrace to ensure diversification of its economy, but as well as creating employment opportunities.
ESG has always been an important subject within the energy sector, especially the environment.
What we're seeing is that service providers, whether they are lenders, banks, or even insurance providers, everybody wants to understand what is our ESG strategy and what are the initiatives that we're taking? What are the targets that we're setting for ourselves? And how are we going to go about achieving those targets and further developing with an ESG mindset? And organizations that are developing their ESG strategy and that actively working towards achieving their initiatives and their targets are getting incentives or further support or supply of funding from the market. More banks willing to lend to them. And when those targets are met, there is a direct or even an indirect impact on the cost of funding. When it comes to sustainability and its renewables, projects that come for proposal will want to come with a very clear ESG contribution.
In terms of Oman target for carbon zero by 2050, the oil and gas sector is a major contribution to that target. In terms of technologies, linking that to ESG, of course, we look into some of the best practices when it comes to gas flare reduction and also automation of a lot of processes that would make our operations safer and more cost effective.
Today, things are changing very rapidly and it requires a complete change in leadership. We need to be able to take decisions much faster, which means we need to be more agile. And at the same time, we need to improve our risk appetite to take risks on where we think the market is headed. Finally, we need to look at how we manage data. And data is a very important part of any business today. So it is able to tell us current market trends and customer preferences so that we can adapt to these changes, capitalize on those benefits, but also mitigate any risks that come up.
A governance is an evolving spectrum, and oil and gas specifically is a mature sector when it comes to governance, very much linked with the direction of Oman Vision 2040 in terms of economic growth to talent development, education, R&D, investment, and innovation.
So the future energy mix will not just be hydrocarbons or alternative energy. We expect hydrocarbons to drive the transition into alternative energy such as wind and solar, and the traditional energy sources such as coal and nuclear. The downstream is working in parallel with the upstream to ensure that alternative energy is well augmented with what it needs in order for it to become an energy choice in the future in Oman.
On the roadmap of developing our downstream industries in Oman, capitalizing on the wealth of expertise and knowledge and also the revenues coming from the hydrocarbon-based industry to start fueling the green industries, alternative energies, green molecules, and develop our talents in order to take the lead going forward in this energy transition.
As a country, we have already set ourselves the net zero target by 2050. We are looking at decarbonization, but equally we are looking at advanced hydrogen, whether it is blue hydrogen and green hydrogen, all of that in anticipation that, you know, at the right time, we will make sure that we have the right energy mix for security, affordability, and sustainability as well.